The future is where my destiny awaits. Forgive me, I was lost in a dream. I needed some fresh air and thought to rest for a moment. It would seem I am more fatigued than I realized. Too much time away from the tower, I fear. It drains me, leaves my body frail and weak. Though, in truth, it is debatable whether I can still call this my body. When first I turned my mind towards the salvation of the world, I came to the conclusion that it would take many long years. Many more than remain to me. And so I made myself one with the Crystal Tower, that I might live indefinitely. I am but an extension of it now, hence my weakness the farther I travel and the longer I am away. It has been quite a journey. But thanks to you, the end is in sight. My wish will finally be fulfilled. How goes the construction effort? Then this may be the last moment we have to ourselves for a while. Come, sit with me. Tell me, when all of this is over, what will you do? Even should we succeed in forestalling the 8th Umbral Calamity, the specter of war will remain. But to declare your intent with such easy resolve, you truly are a hero's hero, my friend. But whatever it is you decide to do, I have every confidence that you will do well, for you have the strength to forge your own path. You will leave countless lives better than you found them, and the souls you touch will never forget your kindness. Then, in trying times, when you question your worth and your choices, they will raise their voices to remind you of the difference you have made. And thus will your deeds come to affirm your path. Remember this. When this is over, indeed. I once told you that there are things we can ill afford to lose. Things, I said, though in truth, I spoke of a person, one who is unaware of the full extent of my plans. Though he deserves to know, I have good reason to keep my counsel. I have come to terms with this in my mind, yet my heart yearns to lay everything bare. For he is my inspiration, and I would give much and more for the chance to speak with him as friends, with no thought of concealment. Should he indulge me with his tales, I would regale him with my own about my efforts in Norvrand, perhaps. Though, ultimately, that tale is more yours than it is mine. Then, I would ask him about his next adventure. And if he should wish me to be a part of it, oh, how happy it would make me. Together we would travel the lands and cross the seas and take to the skies upon the eternal wind. My heart swells simply to imagine it. But all of this is contingent upon our victory in the coming battle. The people of this world have entrusted their hopes to us. We cannot fail them. Nor those who roused me from my slumber. Thank you for your company, my friend. Let us return to Amity.